We had assumed the president was refusing to help us with testing because he was making a political calculation. But regrettably, we may have been wrong. Today, this president gave us reason to believe that his judgment may not just be bad, it may be impaired. Did you hear this?
He's going to do things that nobody ever would ever think even possible. Take away your guns, destroy your Second Amendment, no religion, no anything, hurt the Bible, hurt God. He's against God.
Those are the rantings of someone shouting at the sky and hoping for spare change. A man responsible for my and your family really believes that a political opponent is trying to hurt God and hurt the Bible, whatever that means. I mean, did he find that wisdom in that 2 Corinthian part of the good book that he made up? If Trump wants devoutness to be a measure, remember what he knows about the Bible.
2 Corinthians, right? 2 Corinthians 3:17. That's the whole ballgame. Where the Spirit of the Lord, right? Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. And here there is Liberty College, but Liberty University. But it is so true. You know, when you think, and that's really, is that the one? Is that the one you like?
Well, he's always looking for what you like. But he's the only Christian I've ever known who says he's never needed God's forgiveness. He's the only Christian I know who's almost never been seen attending a service. But the time has come to look past his faith. It is time to look at this man's behavior through the lens not just of a man who simply lacks moral agency, but perhaps basic cogency. This man wants to talk about hurting God when he gassed Americans exercising their First Amendment rights to protest injustice in America. Remember, the head of the Joint Chiefs had to apologize for even being there for that scene. They were protesting injustice that is anathema to Jesus's message. Injustice that Trump denies even exists in this country. And remember why he did it. For a photo op, holding a Bible, which he was asked about and answered this way.
Is that your Bible?
It's a Bible.
Is it your Bible? It's a Bible. I mean, is this about being devout or just dumb? He doesn't know whose it is. He doesn't know what's in it. He certainly doesn't know how to live by the message, but he wants to talk about being a good Christian? A man who puts kids in cages because he likes the message it sends? I don't think, though, that this is just about faith. I mean, I really believe it is time to take a look at his fortitude.